Hey guys, Dr. Prometheus here, back with some more of our Millennium Dawn Plans the US. And so after two of the episodes went live, and there's still one more left, I had a comment that said that without having the AI nuclear strike, like first strike out, the AI only responds to nuclear attacks of the player, and that kind of defeats the purpose because we're not going to preemptively nuclear strike anyone. So that essentially takes out like a lot of this stuff in here from really being anything realistic. So what I did is I restarted, got about to the point where I was, which was about 2002-2003, about the same amount through the focus tree, which we were about in here anyways, and I've researched a couple of things over here to get. So we are there. We've already done everything with Afghanistan. We're prepared to go in Iraq. So we're kind of out with that, so it's all good. I expanded the Korean forces, renamed a lot of stuff besides these two. I'll rename those between episodes, but renamed them for real units, things like that, nicknames. Some of them are units that have been disbanded over time, either from Vietnam or after Korea, World War II. There's a couple that were done after Desert Storm, so kind of did all that. The Navy is good, the Air Force is good. What we're doing here is we had a 30% tick down, which would make this the Raptor like come in 2 years before. It's still going to take us a lot of time. It'll probably get up by like 2008-2009 maybe, so we'll have the F-22 and we'll be able to field those. Pretty much the same point where we were at technology wise. I've been constructing buildings like no other. I had a comment that said, yeah, we can tick down this, but I kind of want to put it to where the point that we have to balance the budget towards expenditure as opposed to the other way around. And our biggest expenditure is actually these factories costing us money. So we're not going to accept any more of these. And we're just going to build our own up from there. So playthrough might be a little slower on the movement around because I did burn my hand because I'm dumb. So we'll just leave it at that. No big deal, though. We'll keep on pushing through. It just hurts like hell. So let's do it. Might hear the air conditioning on as well, and well, that's on because it's hot outside. Oh, what I also did was I created China to be a hegemony. So essentially they're going to go with Chinese dominance. So there's going to be conflict in Asia. I did the same thing as Russia. I made Russia go with the united focus, which will take him down Putin and eventually go down and do all of this. Which will ultimately move down all the way into some wars. So we're going to have some wars in this 100%. Charles, dude, we're going with the MRAPs. asking, that's probably best. And the next slot will be up to get that other army point. We also had Italy leave NATO for whatever reason. They are going non-aligned right now, so we're trying to boost them into coming out. Ukraine, so Poroshenko is non-aligned. So I'm going to wait to the end of the year to do that. The current debt is 16 billion. Just technically 16 trillion. Okay, Somalia. A civil war is over. At these issues in Myanmar. Which is going to be more towards China. If that is the case, we're going to play the influence campaign. I think that's probably the best thing to do is the influence campaign. Okay, SCO. China's being increasingly militaristic in their exercises. We just have to make sure Australia doesn't... Can't let Australia fall, obviously. South Africa probably already. Yeah, they're going emerging outlook. Let's approve relations with Brazil and reduce Chinese influence in Brazil. Okay. We got Revival Rust Belt. It's adding building slots. I'm looking for... So those just add buildings, generally speaking. Okay. which I think is what I'm trying to do, is our GDP increases as we get these buildings in. So we're going to keep on pumping towards that. Think about that. That is increasingly expensive as the US. Jeez. I didn't notice that. Obviously, we're going to do an expansion of NATO. Which we're going to improve relations with all NATO countries, obviously. So that must mean that the additional expenses is not from this. Ah. It's from this. It's gonna take a long time to get up to upgrades. We're getting 4 tanks a week. In a year, that'll be... That's almost 2 years. We do have tons of small arms, we just don't have anyone upgraded. Go negligible corruption. Maybe Italy isn't in NATO from the start. I always thought they were. I thought they entered in the 70s. I know France has pulled out and re-entered multiple times. The Midwest back to working. Oh, that's one a day. That's a lot of tanks. Okay, what do I need to get in Maine? Civilian factory? I'll take one. So obviously we're going to call in the invasion of Iraq later on in the year. We're on October. Yeah, what was killing my thing is this. We're slowly getting there. GDP wise. Okay. So we're gonna just pound straight through Iraq. I don't think that's gonna be that much of an issue. Yes, sir. Okay, that's cool. They move along the rail. I think that supply will increase as we when we attack. War tension isn't crazy large by any means. Okay, let's go up to speed 5. So we're just kind of waiting for things to happen. Building up. Getting the F-22 would be nice. Get the fixed wing aircraft and the DARPA boost. Finally got to the point where we're stuck. Right? Or maybe we need both of those decisions. Yes, it requires this. Okay. Let's go National Guard. And the next one we're going to do, we're going to expand NATO. I think we're to the point where that's the smart thing to do. There's so many F-16s, it's insane. I did not realize that the U.S. had that many F-16s at one point. Wow, that's gonna take a lot. Okay, we're gonna do it. September, it's about time. George Bush petitions the UN for the war in Iraq.
watch it.
Because of the invasion of Iraq, we are going to expand the National Guard for occupation reasons. Better cells, then we're gonna have MRAPs early, technically. MRAPs didn't come in until like 2008. 2006, maybe? It was a couple years after the invasion. Okay, what we're gonna do? Oh, we're gonna justify. Can we justify this? Now we have to wait. Maybe it's through a decision. Scan Eagle. NATO expansion. come up with the striker. I mean, it makes sense that we're doing both the striker concepts at the same time. I'm kind of hoping Italy does not split. Well, that's going to be... Italy might need some democracy after this. It may. Okay, we're... Okay, we're going to declare it. It's a military factory. So Slovenia, Slovakia, Romania, Lithuania, Latvia, Estonia, Bulgaria. Let's go. We're obviously going to reassure Japan. Okay, we're going to go down the military. In Colorado. Logistical strikes. Ready. Ready for war. That's weird. I'm not sure how you launched that. Okay, that should be good. I didn't think that would take that long. Looks like we're doing it a summer war. No big deal. We'll do it in this episode, so. No big deal with that. Some laughs coming out. Gonna take some time for MRAPs. Wait, what? They went nationalist. Wow. No, we're just traveling through Iraq. Cause it's hilarious. War in Iraq. Do you have a couple comments on this? I actually remember watching the Shock and Awe campaign in 2004. I was in high school at the time. I remember it was probably being someone that obviously wasn't old enough during the Cold War by any means. By the time it ended, I was like maybe two or three. So it was on the back end. The war was pretty much over at that point. And obviously I wasn't alive during Vietnam and the whole thing of that matter, having everything televised. Seeing a war televised on TV was just completely, I wouldn't say something new by any means, but it was something completely like out of the movies. It was insane to say the least. Okay, so we're just gonna hit it. We're gonna go in on our own. Okay. So from the start, we are hitting them hard. Their armor brigades just cannot stand up to this. Those SUs and F-16s and... We're just south of Alaya, of Babylon. Ready, sir. Attention. Ready. Move out.
Listen up. Ready to move.
So we get the Ramadi. just outside Baghdad now. Where are my close air support? And Baghdad is under our control. I'll take it. We're slowly growing our economy. I'm not sure if we're going to grow it fast enough, but I am not going to, I'm not going to just put them out there.
Attention.
Okay, we got some fox bats, fish beds, and some other equipment. Nothing crazy.
to move.
Our soft, what we're gonna do, this is how we're gonna hold the Pacific.
Attention.
Okay. That's the end of that. We're gonna send as many teams as we can overseas. Get the 442nd back into Texas. Okay. Okay. So that's going to be it for this episode. We take on Iraq. I think at this point, Iran is a part of the SCO. I'm unsure if the idea is to invade Iran. If we have a situation to where maybe Saudi Arabia somehow gets toppled, which is possible, however highly unlikely, we might do that. We'll see when their election comes due. And also, we will have a Syrian question sooner rather than later of what to do with that. But as of right now, we're just going to hang out. We're going to chill with Iraq. It's Abdul Rahman Bakar. I don't remember. Alright, so that's going to be it for this episode, guys. Thank y'all for joining me. Go ahead and leave a like below, comment, and subscribe, and we will see if we can continue the expansion of NATO and counter possible Russian aggression into Europe, as well as counter the Shanghai Pact in China in Asia. So I will see you guys next time. Later.